And welcome back to the Red Booth Show. I'm here with the Wynter Twins, and also Todd McCaffery has joined us, who is co-authoring of their new book with you guys. So why don't you show us some of these new books that you have?
Let's go with yours first, because you did the cover.
Yes, so this is The Right Path World Building. So we actually talk about how we all created our book, Wynter Wayvern. So step by step.
And this is the Wynter Wayvern, which is the book we created while writing the book on creating worlds.
So. That makes sense.
Did that make sense?
It's the equivalent of behind-the-scenes documentary in book form to that book.
Ah, so this tells the story of what it was like all along while you're going
how you're building
the
world.
Yeah, so our first initial book in the Right Path series talks about, like, it's how to write the skeleton of a book. This goes in how to write an entire universe that goes around it. For example, you know, Star Wars is a universe. There's Lord of the Rings. You can write from different character perspectives and different timelines. So that's what we teach in this book.
Cool.
And then you can read the book, Wynter Wayvern. In either order, really.
Yeah, you can. It's fine.
Or either one.
Or both at the same time.
If you're really adventurous.
Yes.
And what would you say the main story is in this book?
Oh, can I do the famous blurb?
There we go.
Kreia was bored. And when she was bored, bad things always followed.
Dun, dun, dun! Sorry, I couldn't.
I know, we needed the sound effects, seriously.
It's us.
I had to.
It's part of the process, you know. Life without sound effects.
So it's gas lamp fantasy. So set in a completely fantasy world. And our main character has an encounter with a wyvern.
But it changes her life forever. She accepts a gift from a dying wyvern that doesn't seem like much of a gift at all after she wakes up with no memory of what happened the day before.
Oh.
Bum, bum, bum. That was
appropriate.
There you go.
So we had a lot of fun writing.
This is so cool that you guys are working together. Obviously, you have a huge history in writing, and, you know, your mom was just a legend, and also you are with all of your amazing books.
Yep.
And I know you guys were talking about how you came together, so I thought that'd be a cool story as well.
So we're presenting at Writers of the Future, which is an incredible writing contest, and Todd is a judge. And we just happened to sit next to each other, and we both started talking about abstract art, which is abstract.
And art.
Oh my goodness. Yeah. So it's rare. I mean, we like the same kind of art. We just started talking, and we realized that we had everything in common. And so we went art supply shopping together, and we've been BFFs ever since.
Nice. That's amazing. Yeah.
But you know, even since then, when I first started losing my vision, and I thought it was something temporary, I thought I can get a surgery to fix it, which is not the case. He sat me down and said, you know, Britt, I will be your eyes and help you write for as long as you need me to. And if it ends up being permanent, that's forever. And I went, wow, this is really, he's amazing. And we actually ended up writing together. And now I'm actually using technology that makes it so I can write on my own. But
that's cool.
Brianna and Todd has both helped me through this last year. And I've been able to write multiple books, even though I'm partially sighted.
You know, it's been amazing to watch you go through this experience of losing your vision. I remember when you first were talking about it, and it was just like unbelievable, the idea that you would suddenly have lost your vision.
Yeah.
And we all thought it was temporary, or hoped it was temporary.
Yeah.
I mean, I still do hope it's temporary.
Mm-hmm.
But to see you go through this, and, you know, not only with such poise and such determination, it's amazing. It's like you barely can even tell that you went blind.
Thank you so much. You know, it's interesting. When you first lose your vision overnight, you first go, oh my God, the world around me is going dark, right? And that, it's very scary. But as you start going to doctors and brain doctors, and there's all types of doctors that you go to, you go a lot. You go once or twice a week, and you see people in the lobbies over and over again. Then sometimes those people don't come back. But it's not because they are cured, it's because they've passed away. So I'm fortunate that what I have is not deadly, and there's a lot of people that don't have that. What I have is so rare, it's far more probable to get a brain tumor or cancer of some kind. So I feel very fortunate to be here. It's just a perspective change that you just have to see for yourself. I joined a lot of groups online as well for people that had lost their vision suddenly, and most of the people that started that group are not here around anymore. They passed on. So I feel very fortunate.
And we are very fortunate.
Yeah, I feel very fortunate to be here.
Well, definitely so. I mean, both of you have had a very amazing life because you also started off, as you said, you know, premature.
Yeah.
And then you went on to become award-winning authors.
Yep.
At a very young age. And I think we talked about this when you were on the show before, but I think your first big novel came out when you were like 11 or 12?
12, mm-hmm. Yep, and went national on our 13th birthday. So we were at a very high point in our career. We were in talks for a television show and things were going really well the month before I went and I lost my vision. So it was an interesting point. We were at the high point of our career when everything just kind of went stalled. But, I mean, it worked out. So.
And an unexpected side effect from it was that, you know, it made us sit and think about what was important. And the transformation in our writing, particularly in Britt's writing, has been unbelievable. Everything she does, I look at now and think, wow, that is an adult voice. Yeah. Who is this woman? Is that my twin? Yeah. I can't believe we're genetically identical.
Yeah. And I mean, we've all been on the journey together. Yeah. Todd was there every step of the way.
Yeah.
Oh, well, okay. This is such an amazing story, but we have to take a quick break.
All right.
We'll be right back with the Wynter Twins and Todd McCaffery. Thanks so much for watching my interview with the Wynter Twins and Todd McCaffery. You can continue to watch the rest of our episode by clicking here.